Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Chemical Engineering Knowledge. In this lecture we will discuss about the mass balances on open system. Mass balances on open system. In the previous lecture we have already discussed about the closed system. So this was a closed system, the piston cylinder assembly. This was a gas molecule. We said that we can keep the gas molecule in a piston cylinder assembly either by conduction or radiation or some other heating medium. So this was closed system. Similarly, we also said that this was a water and its surface was closed, upper surface was closed, there was some water. This is the water. Now we said that when we give some heat to the water will gain heat, some of the water will evaporate. Will be evaporated and some of the water will be condensed again to the liquid water. So we said that this is the closed system. Mass cannot enter and mass cannot leave this system boundary. The system boundary. So this was our closed system. Similarly, this is also closed system. Now take the same beaker, place some water in it, but in this case the upper surface of the beaker is open to the air. Now give some heat to it. When we give heat to the water, this is water. We give some heat to the water. Water molecule will gain some heat. It will convert it from liquid state to the vapor to the gaseous state. To the gaseous state. So the liquid water will convert it to the gaseous state and it will transfer to the surrounding air. Transfer to the surrounding air. So if we take boundary around the open system, so in this case mass crosses the boundary of the open system. So this is the case of, this is the case of open system. This is our open system because mass crosses the boundary. This was, suppose this was imaginary boundary, so mass crosses the boundary of a system. So this is open system and this one is the closed system. These two are the closed system. Now our main focus here is not on the closed system, but we will discuss the open system and the mass balance on the open system. So let us take an open system. An open system like this one. This is some water. We give some heat. Then water evaporated from liquid to the vapor state. So this is open system. Now the general energy balance equation for the open system is, now the general mass balance equation for the open system is the material or mass enter to the system, input to the system minus mass output from the system, this mass generated in the system minus mass consumed in the system is equal to mass accumulated in the system. So input minus output plus generation, input minus output plus generation minus consumption is equal to accumulation. This is the general material balance equation. Now for the open system like this one, what will be the mass balance? So here we are considering only mass, not energy. So the mass is not mass input, so there is no input mass entering to the system. Output mass, yes, there is output mass from the system. So the output mass is this one. These are the output mass which leave the system. So output mass is present. This is mass generation. No, there is no chemical reaction, so mass generation is zero. Mass consumption. So mass consumption, is there is any mass consumption in the system? So mass consumption Here mass consumption is, yes, there is mass consumption. Mass is decreases with the passage of time, and mass is not accumulated. Mass is not accumulation, not accumulated in the system. So the mass which is output from the system is equal to the mass which consumed in the system. So minus consumption is equal to zero, or output mass is equal to minus consumption. So this is the mass balance for this open system. Now what will be some other mass balance equation? So the other mass balance equation is like, suppose this is our system. Fluid is entering to the system. Mass and fluid is leaving the system. The mass out, the mass entering. So the entering mass, suppose it is the mass flow rate at the entering flow, mass flow rate at the output flow. And there is some liquid in the system. This is our system. Now the mass entering and the mass out. And there is some mass accumulated also in the system. So mass changes with the passage of time, dm by dp. So mass changes in the system with the passage of time. So suppose the entering mass to the system is 5 kilogram per second, but the leaving mass, the mass which leaves the system, suppose it is 2 kilogram per second. Then how much mass will accumulate in the system? It will be just 5 minus 2. It will be 3 kilogram of mass will accumulate in this system in 1 second. So this will be the accumulation. Now what will be the general mass balance equation on this system? It will be equal to a mass flow rate which enter to the system, mass minus mass flow rate out from the system, is equal to mass accumulated in the system. So this is the mass balance equation for this system. Now if there are two entering mass, suppose one fluid is entering from this side, another fluid is entering from this side, and suppose two outlet, one is from this side, fluid is out, an outlet is this one, one outlet is this one. So two inlet and two outlet. So suppose two inlet, this is inlet number one, this is inlet number two, and this is outlet number three, and this outlet number four. So inlet mass flow rate 1 plus mass flow rate 2 with the inlet minus mass flow rate 3 with the outlet, mass flow rate 4 with the outlet, is equal to mass accumulated. So this is for the two system, for the two stream which entering and leaving the system. For n stream which enter to the system and n stream which are leaving the system, this equation number 2 will become equal to summation of mass flow rate which enter to the system minus summation of the mass flow rate which leave the system, will be equal to the change in mass with the passage of time in this system. So this will be the for n number component, for many streams, this equation will be used. If there are 3, 4, 5 or any number of stream which are entering or leaving the system, so we will use this equation for many streams. So similarly at steady state, this equation will become equal to mass accumulation term will be equal to 0. So mass inlet will be equal to mass output. So at steady state this will be also equal to 0. So mass flow rate entering the system will be equal to mass flow rate output from the system. So entering mass will be equal to the outlet mass at steady state. Now what will be the some other equation for the mass flow rate, for the mass balance is it? So we know that mass balance can be written as mass flow rate n minus mass flow rate out equal to change in mass with the question of time. We can also write this equation, suppose this equation 1, we can also write it as this, that density is equal to mass flow rate divided by volumetric flow rate, and mass flow rate is equal to density into volumetric flow rate. And we can also say that volumetric flow rate for unit area is equal to velocity. So volumetric flow rate is equal to velocity into area. So in place of volumetric flow rate, we will write velocity into area. So mass flow rate will be equal to density, velocity into area. So in place of this, we will write the density of the inlet fluid, the velocity of the inlet fluid area through which inlet fluid passes, minus the density of the outlet fluid, the velocity of the outlet fluid, and the area through which outlet fluid passes is equal to change in mass in the passage of time. So at steady state, this term will be equal to 0, and the density at the inlet will be equal to density of the outlet fluid, velocity of the outlet fluid, and area through which outlet fluid passes from system to surrounding is air outlet. So if inlets, if there is incompressible fluid, then the inlet density will be equal to outlet density, they will be cancelled. So suppose inlet is denoted by, suppose we will denote inlet term by 1. So A1 V1 is equal to A2. A2 V2. The output is denoted by 2 here. So A2 V2. So this is nothing but the continuity equation. A2 V2. So A2 can be written as A1 V1 divided by V2. Area 1, velocity 1. Area 1, velocity in the area 1. And velocity 2, velocity at point 2. And area at point number 2. So area at point number 2, area at point number 1, velocity at point number 1, velocity at point number 2. So point number 1, suppose point number 1 is inlet and point number 2 is outlet. Suppose this is 1. Suppose this is our system. This is point number 2. And this is, suppose this is point number 1. So and this is system. So these are the this is the continuity equation. Now we can also write the mass balance equation over interval of time. So mass balance over interval of time. Mass balance over interval of time. Mass balance over interval of time. Let's mean that in how much time, how much mass will enter the system, how much mass will accumulate in a system, and how much mass will leave in the system. Suppose this is a lake. This is a lake. The inlet fluid is, the fluid is entering. Mass of the fluid is entering, and mass of the fluid is outlet. And some of the, and some of the mass, some of the water. Suppose the water is entering to the lake, the water is leaving the lake, this one, and this is the lake. And the water which accumulated in the lake is, suppose, MA, mass accumulated. So we will, in some cases, we are interested to find that in how much time, how much mass will be accumulated in the lake, how much water will be entered to the lake during a time interval, and how much time water will leave the lake over interval of time. So suppose someone is interested to find the how much mass will accumulated in this lake in the month of July, and it will depend on the inlet water and the outlet water during the month of July. So it is nothing but mass balance in this case will be written as mass of water accumulated in lake during the month of July will be equal to mass of water enter to the lake during the month of July minus mass of water leaving the lake this one, and this is the mass of water entering to the lake is this one, leaving the lake during the month of July. So it will mathematical in mathematical or in symbol form, the mass of water accumulated in the lake will be equal to mass of water. Suppose A is suppose mass of water accumulated in the lake is A, it will be equal to mass of water entering to the lake and minus the mass of water outflow from the lake. So mass of water accumulated in the lake during the month of July will be written as NA. Mass of water which entered to the lake during the month of July will be written as this MIN, mass enter to the lake during the month of July, and the mass coming out from the lake during the month of July will be this one or this one. So this is a simple mass balance on open system. So this was all about the mass balances on the open system on a time interval basis. We derived the mass balance equation similarly on rate basis. We also derived the mass balance equation on rate base also. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much.